I was subjected to media trial. I was subjected to trollers and haters, which again were derived from media trials. I don't want empathy. I'm beyond that. I had gone through it inside, but she had to face a lot outside. And she said, you know what, already, you know, the reputation's been destroyed, Raj. And I heard her side of the story first. And then I said, I'm just going to tell you mine. I'm broken, I'm lost, and I need to find myself. It's humiliating because wo nangai kar dete aapko. And then they're checking that if you're carrying any narcotics in your backside and everything, and they literally strip you down in front of everyone. So you just feel like you've lost all your dignity when that happens. You know, you just feel like, gosh, you've gone through so much already, ab yahan pe bhi nanga kar rahe hai. It was a difficult phase. Nikal gaya wo time. We have separated.
Raj, Shahnawaz, welcome to Pinkvilla.
Thank you, Raj.
So, you know, at the trailer launch, Raj, you said, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Now that's such a true line. When an incident like this happens in your life, your equity is at stake, your self-confidence is at stake. Till the time the court really takes this to some kind of a judgment, people will still always look at you from the perspective of a doubt.
Yep.
In all of this, what gave you the confidence to still make a film on the same subject that is still sub judice?
So we don't touch upon the case at all. So the way I tell people is, if you want to treat it any differently, just put the case aside. There's a person, and this is his journey inside one of the most notoriously overcrowded jails in India. Watch it not just for me, but watch it for the content it gives you with what would happen if you just put a celebrity's husband into a barrack which is made for 50 people and there are 250 people inside, who gets connected with all these 250, the journey, the friendships, the emotions. And there's so much more to learn and understand. So there's a big hoo-ha of this jail.
Yeah.
Everyone's heard about it because many celebrities go there. It's our Mumbai jail. So if anyone's done wrong, that's where you go. And to actually see that my slice of life and to actually understand, acha, ye hai jail, iske andar ye hota hai, aise hota hai, it'll open your eyes. And I don't think it's ever been done. We've seen many jail movies, but there's no one who's been inside to come out to tell you ka ye hai.
Yeah.
Other than Sanju, which touched upon it a bit, and that's a jail.
Yeah.
This is a detention center.
Yeah.
You've heard about it, everyone's heard about it, but no one's seen it.
Yeah.
You get to see it through my eyes now.
Sure. But you know, like I said, there will be so much of judgment. See, there will be two very clear people. There will be some people who will be empathizing with you. Then there will be some
people I don't want empathy. I'm beyond that. When you internally know you've done no wrong and you've fallen prey to whatever's happened, I think you just have to go ahead, take it on the chin and wait for the laws of the land to announce a decision. I was subjected to media trial. I was subjected to trollers and haters, which again were derived from media trial. So I don't blame anyone. Everyone's doing their job, everyone's doing their bit. I just know that when the judiciary announces me guilty, not guilty, that's the day you have to really sort of worry, not worry about it. And I know internally I've done no wrong. I'm not guilty of any of the allegations against me. So when you're confident to that level, then you can come out and do this. Anyone who wasn't would not do this.
Yeah.
They would say, forget it, boss, not writing, not talking. I don't want to show this class of my life because I'm a self-made man and I've built this status that Raj Kundra, the millionaire, he's right up here. And suddenly I've shown living like a commoner.
Yeah.
But I've started from there, boss. I was a taxi driver at the age of 18. So I have no qualms. I have nothing that says, oh yeah, I can't show this side of my life. I went through it, I'll show it.
But then, Raj, like I said, the judgment of whitewashing your image will also come along with this film. If it came for Sanju, it will come for this also.
I think the trailer shows that it's not a whitewash. I think you would also believe that after seeing the trailer and allowing the director to have so much bad said about me because he read the notes, he read everything I wrote inside. I made a diary of each and everything that happened inside. And these things happen. When Shilpa was on TV, they say, she's looking damn hot. And somebody said, yaar, uska pati yahan baitha hai, chup kar. So I had to go through that. It was the class of life of the people around me. That's their understanding and that's their thought. Unki samajh hi utni level tak hai. So I was okay with it. You know, if I'm showing you what has actually happened, what I went through. It was an interesting group, interesting mix of people. And when you put a British citizen who's come from abroad, doesn't understand how the system works, and gets stuck in one of the most worst, overcrowded, notorious jails, humor aayi jaati hai, and you laugh at it. I laugh at it today, and I laughed at it then also. So when I wrote it, it was very satirical, the way I was writing it at that time. You know, it felt like a black comedy there and then. So I was writing his notes, and I was laughing to myself. It was a serious matter. I'll just give an example. When I ask somebody, ka bhai, main toilet pe nahi baithunga. Indian toilet, I can't squat, I have any problem. Can I get an English toilet? Haan, English toilet hai andar. English toilet tha, but it was just a commode kept separate. not attached to anything. Tha. Oh God. But usable hai.
Yeah.
So it was funny, but at the same time, it was painful. So
clearly.
Yeah. So clearly. That's the way we've projected that and the film. So if you've liked the trailer, you'll love the film because we've not taken just the best bits and put it in the trailer. The film has so much more to show. 63 days of what happened in 2 hours. There's lots of content.
Yeah. Shahnawaz, when, you know, I first heard that Raj is making a film like that, it was not officially announced by then. And I'll be honest, my first reaction was, really? Yeah. Is he really doing that? Why is he making a film on such a hard time of his life? When he came to you with the idea for the first time, what was your reaction? And did at some...
I didn't go to him. He'll tell the story.
Yeah. And did you feel like warning him, ke mat karo?
No, it was the other way around actually. So we were working on something else before. It was an action comedy. Mm. And then this whole episode happened. And then when he came out, I went to meet him. I wanted to know, you know, how are you? And then he was broken actually. And then he said, yeah, zyada poochta nahi hu, bataunga nahi zyada. This is a book that I've written, like pages. I want to make into a book. Just read it. So I went back, read it, showed it to my wife. She's the producer of the film, EP. And then I showed it to my writer, his notes, and immediately it stuck to us, it's a better film. It will be definitely better than the film. And the way he was writing his journal every day, a lot of humor, a lot of pain, a lot of smiles, a lot of sorrows, everything was there. So that was the, so it was us who convinced him, yaar, film banate hai, book mat likho. And then somehow he agreed, yeah, chal, theek hai, bana lete hai, film bana lete hai. So he says, okay, kisko lenge? So I said, ek hai. लेना चाहिए, इट्स यू राज, सो न्यू कमर है. सो लाइक देख बेटा, यहाँ तक ठीक था, अभी मतलब घर से भी बाहर निकल आएगा तो लाइक यू नो, सो लेट्स नॉट डू दिस. टिकटॉक अलग है, फिल्म अलग है, एंड वी डोंट वांट टू गो थ्रू दिस अगेन. यू नो, यू डोंट वांट पीपल टू टॉक, गिव समथिंग एल्स टू टॉक अबाउट इट. बट देन वी नरेटेड हिम द स्टोरी, सो एज यू सेड, वी डिडंट टॉक अबाउट द केस, वी डिडंट टॉक अबाउट मीडिया ट्रायल, वी डिडंट टॉक अबाउट हिज लाइफ, बिकॉज इट्स नॉट अ बायोपिक, इट्स बेस्ड ऑन अ ट्रू इंसिडेंट, ट्रू स्टोरी, हैपेंड his phase of his life. So, and then he understood, he agreed, and then the biggest challenge was ki, oh, now how to convince Shilpa.
Yeah.
And then itself it was a different story. Then that was another battle that he won for us.
She apparently threw a chopper at you.
she was ready to. I think convincing her was it was going to be hard on many levels because I know what she had went through outside. I had gone through it inside, but she had to face a lot outside. And she said, you know what, already, you know, the reputation's been destroyed, Raj. And I heard her side of the story first. And then I said, I'm just going to tell you mine. I'm broken, I'm lost, and I need to find myself. I've hit an all-time low. I never thought this would happen. It's collateral damage to an extent that I am Shilpa Shetty's husband. So that name carries a lot of weight, and it became as viral as it did. Had I just been any random person's husband, it wouldn't have been so viral. There's a pain, and I want to get rid of this pain, and I need closure. And I felt somewhere after hearing the story that if I did this, I felt internally, if I could show the world what I had gone through and what others are going through inside, it's a story beyond me, it's above me, and that there's a strong message in it. It'll give me closure, and one fine day when the courts announce their judgment, I'll feel happy that I've done this, and people will one day then relate this to this and say, you know what, nobody should go through this. Yeah. Nobody, not me, not anyone. They're accused, they're not guilty yet.
Yeah.
To put them through the kind of life they're going through inside jail was very disheartening and very sad. So I connected with a lot of people inside. I've tried to help a lot of people when I've come out who've got their bail and just don't know how to get out because they don't have people outside. They don't know how to pay the $500 and get out of the system. So I've done whatever I could and I want to continue doing it. I've set up a small legal aid. It's not enough though. I think that there are requirements for certain reforms to happen, and I hope the movie sends out that message and people see it and say, okay, you know what, accused ko thoda different treat karna chahiye. In fact, there are fundamental rights for even those who are guilty and have gone to jail. Yeah. There are basic necessities that everyone deserves in life. The basic fundamental rights are taken away, it's a violation of human rights in many ways.
You know, in Jigna Vora's book, the girl just
beautiful. I read that inside.
Scoop. Correct. Yeah. She also narrates an incident about once she was asked to strip, and it was a traumatizing experience for her. It happened with you also.
Of course, it's in the trailer.
But what was that time like? I mean, is there any incident that you see today even and you get goosebumps, you get unnerved? You know,
it's humiliating because wo nangai kar dete aapko. And then they're checking that if you're carrying any narcotics in your backside and everything, and they literally strip you down in front of everyone. So you just feel like you've lost all your dignity when that happens. You know, you just feel like, gosh, you've gone through so much already. Ab yahan pe bhi nanga kar rahe hai. The media to nanga kar hi rahi thi mujhe. Upar se ye bhi ho gaya. So I felt very disheartened and hurt. You weren't getting proper food. You weren't getting a proper place to sleep. You're hearing banter. You're hearing people talk about you, your wife, in very lecherous ways. It was hurt. I was hurt. You know, and it saddened me, unfortunately. But I realized that you were with such walks of life, and you have to understand. And I don't know why I was not put in the other barracks where so-called celebrities go. Maybe I'm not a celebrity or whatever. But they put me in the common barrack, and I had no qualms about that. I wasn't looking for any VIPs. Anything. And not that you get a VIP status when you go to that other barrack. It's still bad, but there's five people living there versus living in a place that's made for 15, 250 people are living there.
Yeah.
So it was really survival of the fittest. You had to just, each day was a new adventure, was a new story. And that's why we have so much to tell in this two-hour movie. It was a difficult phase. Nikal gaya wo time bhi.
Mask came on because you were upset with the press?
Absolutely. I just didn't like the way they... There was a lot of yellow journalism, you know, it was like borderline, really crossing the line. And I said, you know, you have a problem with me, you speak to me, you talk about me. You don't have to bring my wife into it, my kids into it, my family into it. It became... I was humiliated, you know, it was horrible the way they were just attacking. And I felt sorry for Shilpa. I was dealing with it inside. And I didn't have to answer much to the people inside, but she was dealing with everyone outside. She had to answer to her brand, she had to answer to my parents, her mum, the kids she had to look after, schooling she had to take care of, her work. She was dealing with a lot, and I really feel sorry for her. It was unfortunate, but I think she realized what a strong woman she is. I always knew, and I think she needed to see that because, you know, when you're married, you're sort of dependent.
Yeah.
Husband will manage this, wife will manage this, we move on together, and we're best friends, so we work together really well in tangent. When she had to take over everything, she realized she could do much more than she thinks she can do.
Yeah.
So we all learn something, and this adversity teaches us to bring out a different side to ourselves.
Yeah. But Raj, do you remember one conversation that you had with her at about that point in time that maybe gave you all the strength to stay with each other in that time? Because there were so many other rumors of your separation also around that time.
Rumors there, no, us time pe toh.
Correct.
I mean, like I said, baat ek hoti thi, media 10 bolte thi uske baare mein, and that's why that was hurtful. But the rumors never stopped, the media didn't stop, it just continued, and I kept waiting. I said, 10 din, 20 din, 30 din, 50 din, 60 din. It just didn't stop every day, and everyone kept telling me, thoda media mein shanti aa jayegi, bail ho jayega. Because mujhe laga, aaj kal, I'll be out. I didn't think it was going to take so long.
But 63 days.
63 days, and every day something was coming, and I felt like when I'm outside, there was nothing to be said. Raj was Raj, everything was good. Sunday I've gone in, and people I don't even know, random people all jumping on, and matlab mauke pe chauka maare sab. I felt like the whole world had turned against me suddenly. I said, what has happened? It hit me like a ton of bricks. So, I mean, from that point of view, I just didn't know what to say. I just had to deal with it, and Shilpa dealt with it, and she just said one line to me, and I always remember that. And like I said, I was borderline atheist, but she was a big Sai believer. She said, Raj, have faith in Sai, Shraddha Suburi. I said, I'm sleeping next to a picture of Sai, and he doesn't seem very happy with me. Because I used to see this Sai looking at me very angry. And I used to keep looking, I would talk to this Sai Baba Murthy, the photo, and say, sir, aapki beti hai, you know, badi sai bhakt hai, aap usme to daya khao. I said, I'm borderline atheist, I know you don't like me for whatever reason. I kept talking, there was no one else to talk to. I was told I can't talk to anyone, nobody can talk to me, so I should talk to this photo. And somewhere down the line, 30, 40 days into this whole thing, I became a sai bhakt. I started doing part puja and conversations with myself, with my inner soul, with him. Transformed me a little bit. Maybe I had to go inside to become a bit of a God-fearing person. Hey, I am today. Navaratri, keeping all nine fasts and becoming a much more God-loving.
Yeah. You know, someone told me this many years ago that, you know, sometimes we don't believe in astrology, sometimes we don't believe in numerology. Sometimes we don't believe in these things. When it happens on the ground, then maybe a person starts to believe in these
things. 100%.
And you're so right. It does situations like these really test us.
Yeah, it tests us. Absolutely.
True.
Well, that's what happened.
True. Shahnawaz, you know, when you said at the trailer launch that Raj, you joked that Raj was your last resort, but did you guys really consider going to any actor at any point in time? Because obviously he's not a professional actor, and there has to be certain, you know, there are marks and there are scripts and there are dialogues, it's a whole process. Did you have that in mind, that maybe another actor, maybe he suggested anyone?
So yeah, he was quite convinced that we should not take him and do somebody else. But I was quite sure that nahi yaar, banate to aapke saath hi banayenge, otherwise let's not make this project. Otherwise it won't have the weightage and what it deserved to be, this project. So I was very clear. But again, as you said, it's not just like chalo soch liya, bana lenge. Then the whole process of, you know, training oneself, and he did acting classes, he did a lot of workshops, we did a lot of workshops. In workshops, not only actors, in fact the entire crew our DP, our writer, our ADs, our production people, everybody sat together, you know, made a family. We made him forget that this is a crew, and the crew forgot that he is Raj Kundra, and we became one. You know, that's how the preparation went. And we did for days, and he did for months, like the acting classes. He took really good, he took his acting really seriously. You should ask me, what is the emotion, what is the rush that you want from this scene? You know, so I'm like, oh my god, ye meko pucha hai, rush kya chahiye? So I'm like, I have to prepare myself ki main rush kahan se laun dhoond ke. I'm like, haan, mujhe isme. So, you know, that's the kind of question he used to come up with, ki nahi yaar, isme kya rush chahiye? Then all I have to do is like, Raj, you remember, jab aap jail mein the, aapke saath hi, and just, that's it. He used to just go back and suddenly he used to, we all used to feel sorry for him because we constantly used to remind him, you know. And then he used to just go back and then we could see that it's affecting him again.
Yeah.
And again and again over a period of, you know, we shot the film in 19 days.
Oh.
But still those 19 days were like 14 hours long days.
Long
and
days.
Doing this over and over again and again, again and again.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was tough for him, not so tough for me, yeah. You know.
But you took on those tags, like he said right in the beginning, of a pawn king, Shilpa Kapati. Raj, you've treated these tags as humor, but it hurts.
Of course it hurts. I mean, you'd lie if you said it doesn't hurt. But I think I watched one of your recent Pinkvilla interviews where Karan Johar was saying that how he's handling trollers, and I'm literally doing it the same way. I'm just so used to them now over the last 2 years. Same cheese on repeat. Every social media, whenever my post or mass man go out, it's just cut, paste, copy the same thing. You get used to it after a while. You realize that they know no better, you know. And this is their claim to fame. The 10-20 followers, they can just write this and feel good about it. Take it in its spirit. Shilpa said, "Don't complain, don't explain. Just go ahead. You know who you are, what you are. Forget these people." So you get used to it. You have to be a bit thick-skinned in this industry.
Yeah.
You have to wear these sort of blinkers. I was wearing a mask, so it didn't bother me.
Yeah.
But you have to wear blinkers and just go ahead with everything. And I know I've always been a passionate Bollywood buff. I've always enjoyed it since childhood. We grew up watching Bollywood films. So I remember my dad used to come home with the Amitabh Bachchan cassette and we would watch our films. So we were watching films from that day, jo VHS mein hoti thi. So I was always passionate about Bollywood, always loved watching films. We learned Hindi through things. Our first language was Punjabi at home, Punjabi over there in English. So Hindi wahin se sikhi thi. So we said, you know what, let's enjoy it and go. In fact, to an extent that I remember my first acting teacher was Padmini Kolhapuri.
Oh.
Yeah, so she opened an acting school in London. I was 18 then, 17, 18. And I joined her class. I was a favorite student. Huh? So I did 3 months with her. And Daburatani did my first photo shoot at the age of 18. So
wow.
He told me so long. So he joked the other day. He said, 90s mein photo shoot, 23 mein launch. I said, ah, there I drusa hai.
Yeah.
But I think that time was more for the lark. We watched Bollywood films, so we wanted to just go and see. But we didn't have the means or the contacts or the, you know, we didn't have, I couldn't meet ends that time, so
yeah.
I had to go and get a job, I had to work, I dropped out of college. So I remember my first job was packing trays and airline catering, working part-time taxi driver. So self-made, you know, my mom and dad, mom was a housewife, helped my dad also, he was self-made. I wanted to be self-made always. So we've come from the ground up,
yeah.
We were never rich. Koi dada par dadi ki kuch mila nahi hai koi inheritance.
Yeah.
So jo kamaya khud kamaya, jo kiya khud kiya. And I think Shilpa and I connected on that level because she's also self-made and I'm also self-made.
Yeah.
So I've got to thank Padmini ji because she always said, Raj, you have it in you. And then I met her, I went and showed her the trailer. I said, thoda time laga ma'am, but yeh dekho trailer. And she loved it. She goes, Raj, there's no age for an actor. I think you've delivered it so well. Well done. I'm so proud of you. So that was encouraging for me.
Yeah. Your mask have become a style statement. Yeah. Are they going to come back on?
Unfortunately, not.
Thank God.
No. Done. The mask has done its job. I thank it. And we have separated.
Sure.
The mask and I.
Last question. Since you have now taken on acting, you seem to be enjoying the craft.
Yeah.
Any chances to see more of you? Maybe you and Shilpa together?
It's a newcomer. I don't think these A-listers will work with me just yet, but who knows? I never say never anymore, because when I say never, it happens. So
yeah.
Let's just go with the flow, whatever's written in my destiny.
Yeah, sure. No, I can't wait to see UT69.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
3rd November, please make sure your readers go out there and watch it.
For sure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please, you also go and see it.
Bilkul.
Yes.
Pinkvilla, look no further.